You know how people, like homeless people, they beg for money on the
QR code.
Yeah, they have QR codes. There's this new credit card reader called Square. So some homeless people have a phone. They'll have Square. So it's like, oh, you don't have a dollar? I can take credit card. And they show it to you.
It seemed like the minimum tip was like, what, 10-15% or something like that? Yeah. But now, it's like 15% is an insult. You have to tip at least
20-25. Let's find out!
This up again. It is our bread to it is your rice. Is it not?
Money? Yeah.
We call it bread. Like, let's
it's
get
our
this
bread to your rice.
And you guys say, let's get this rice. No? You guys call it rice?
Rice? You got. Bread to you, ne?
Yeah.
Green bam bam bon reaction.撮った時にね、そういう話したよね。ヒップホップの解説で、アメリカではそのお金のことをブレッドっていうっていう、パンっていうっていう。
Yeah. 日本は、He's got that bread.
そう、日本はなんていうのっつって、米起こせっていう話をしたんだけど、ね、まあでもコメント欄でいっぱい、ゆきちって言うって書いてある。
That's why I learned from our wonderful comment section.
そう、僕全然思いついてなかったんだけど、確かに日本はお札のことをゆきちって言うかもしれない。その1万円札のその絵の人がね、福沢諭吉さんだから。まあでもそれもね、もう変わっちゃうと思うから、名前ね、変わると思う。次は一万円札、渋沢栄一さんになるから、栄一とかなるから。
Oh, okay.
健康保険あるよね、日本は。
Okay.
日本で働いてたらみんなも入ってると思いますけども、そうすると、みんな保険料が、まあ大体僕らだったら3割とか。負担でしょ、でなんかそれは例えば海外とかでは実は普通じゃないんだよみたいな話があって、面白いじゃんっていう話の中で今日は日本と海外のお金の感覚の違い考え方の違いとか使い方の違いみたいなところみんなで話していけたらと思ってます。それでは行ってみましょう。1個目、
はい、
健康保険が最高。
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Don't even get me started on this one, dude. Why do you think I'm in Japan? That's all I'm saying, man. I don't want to pay no health insurance in the States, dude. There's so much I have to do on my end. It's like imagine going to the Kyak show to pay health insurance and then you have like, I don't know, 8 or 9 different options for health insurance.
America,
in varying prices, yeah. And imagine if you could only go to one hospital. Like if you have, let's say, Yamamoto Hospital, right? And Taro Hospital. And I only had a Taro Hospital in my area. And I had to go to like 2 cities over to go to Yamada Hospital. Because it's under my health insurance.
あ、そういうこと。どこの病院でも使えるわけじゃなくて。
No.
え、ちょっと待って。まず分かんないのが、アメリカって日本みたいにみんなが入る保険ってある
？No.
まずそこからない。
Well, this is the thing. That's the thing. Like, the government tells you to apply for health insurance, and you have to do that separately. But then you have to say that you are enrolled in health insurance so that they won't deduct it off your taxes. Because if you don't enroll in health insurance, you get your taxes deducted.
Ah,
with a premium.
そういうこと。
So they check to see if you are enrolled in health insurance so that they don't deduct it from your taxes.Right? So, depending on what your tax bracket is and how much money you make, that's how much they charge you for health insurance.
なるほどね。何の保険に入るかっていうのも、国はやってなくて、もうゼロ。
Well, unfortunately.
おお、すごいね。いや、もういいか悪いか分からんけど、まあ、で、自分で保険を、まあ、A 会社の保険なのか、B 会社の保険なのか選ぶってこと？
Yes. Yeah, you pick your health insurance with a certain company, right? And then there's like three levels, like bronze, silver, and like gold health insurance. And gold is like the most expensive. It's like $155 a month or even more if you're in a different tax bracket. Like if you pay for like bronze, it gets you what I was able to afford, or it doesn't even get you anything. Like the premiums cover like 10% of your hospital bills. That means 90% is coming out of pocket. Because you're not paying that much money for health insurance.
Wow.
So if I'm trying to get a CAT scan, which I can easily get for Roxanne inside of Japan, you know how much I'm paying? 30万.
Wow.
For a CT scan. CAT scan.
30万.
Yes, yes. If I'm buying bronze, 10%. They pay 10% of that hospital bill, right? So the original price was 33万, right? So I'm paying 9% out of pocket for my hospital bill. Yeah. And so there's like this big rising debt for like a lot of hospitals, and there's like a lot of it is like forgivable debt, so a lot of people don't pay that, which you shouldn't. They don't, a lot of people do not pay at the end for their hospital bills if they can't afford it, and they just accumulate it as debt. But yeah, some hospitals do acquit that debt because it's just too ridiculous of amount to pay, right?
Jeez.
So I ran to Japan to get better health insurance to take care of myself.
ようこそ日本へ。
Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
アメリカはまあ結構ね、ハードな感じよね。みんなの国どうなの？
In Canada, we have universal healthcare. So, healthcare is free for us.
すご
Yeah, so, but here's a bit of a trick though. Like, it's universal and free in certain situations. So, if you go to your family doctor, if you go to the hospital or emergency or whatever,That's free. You can go to the doctor for free. You don't have to pay anything as long as you have a provincial health insurance card, and that you can get for free. You have to pay to renew it, but that's about it. But in order to enroll in it, you need to prove your residency in that province. But once you do that, you can get a health card for free. But it depends on the province. I don't know like what it's like in other places, but in Ontario at least, you can get a provincial health card and you can get that taken care of for you. But when it comes to things like the eye doctor.Or like a specialist, like GDK or something like that, or like a dermatologist or dentist, that has to be covered out of your pocket, which can get really expensive. And so these specialist things aren't considered like essential healthcare services, I guess.
Oh, it's not within your insurance policy?
Yeah.
They don't include that? That's...
Yeah, yeah. So what you need to do is through your work...You get an insurance, a benefits package, right? And through that benefits package, you get things deducted. So, but the annoying thing is, you first have to pay them full price. So say I go to the dentist, and through my work, I have a benefits package, which allows me to go to the dentist for a percentage of the fee or something like that. It can be sometimes 100%, but that's besides the point. So you first have to pay upfront 100% of the bill yourself, and then you have to claim...that insurance to your insurance provider and they will say yes or no.
Yeah.
Right? So if you're really like hurting for cash or if you max out your credit card and you put it on your credit card, that's still gonna, you're still paying for it to a degree, right?
Yeah.
And it sucks, right? It's terrible and it can get really, really expensive. But like in Japan, you can just show your, what, 保険証
ね?
Yeah. You show your 保険証 and then,That just immediately the deduction gets taken off, right? And then you just pay 30% right there in cash. You can pay in cash and so on, right?
It's
that's
a great
that's
system.
So much better.
I love
so
that.
Much better.
I love that so much.
It's great.
そうね。しかも別に歯医者だろうが耳鼻科だろうが全部だもんね。
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah. I mean, in certain situations, like I prefer the Canadian system because my dad has a few health issues, right? And he had to get a transplant done.If that was in Japan or in America, that would have bankrupted us for sure, like guaranteed, right? But because it was Canada, he didn't have to pay a cent.
What?
Hospital stay, the transplant, the procedure, everything was just zero.
No
way!
Completely
free. So like, it's stuff like that. It's like Canada is amazing when it comes to that type of thing. But
I'm retiring in Canada, and oh my gosh, they're gonna keep me alive forever.
Yeah, but when it comes to like pharmacies and like getting drugs and stuff like that, that does cost money.So, I guess it depends, like, what your health situation is. If you're, like, a healthy, normal person, I think living in Japan is okay because, like, I've gone to the hospital maybe once my entire time here, and that was just a check on an injury I had. But I haven't gone anytime else. So it's pretty cheap. But if I'm like infirmed and like old and really, really frail and I have all these issues where those costs add up eventually, right? So yeah, that's how it works in Canada.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, I go pretty often to the hospital in Japan and man, I'm so glad I don't have to pay American premiums anymore. Yeah. Dude, I have money and I can do things with it instead of just being indebted to all the hospitals in which I owed money back in the States.
Oh man, yeah. I don't know how it works. Like it seems to me the American system is so complicated.
It's very blood-sucking.
Yeah, it's terrible.
I ran away.
America is based on capitalism. Everything has to be
profitable
for them to run. So if they have a chance, they will suck up all the money from you.
Yep.
Like if you're rich, America's probably the best country in the world.
Yes, correct. But
if you're poor, you suck.
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly.
まあ一応日本もその3割って基本的に言ってるけど、一定以上のお金がかかったらそれは高額医療になるから帰ってくる。2人の国は
I'm not so very familiar with the Malaysian system, but what I know is that、we have this thing called SOCSO for 社会人 people who will start working. So they will deduct in your salary deduct every month for like maybe 30 ringgit, which is like 10 yen each month. But then this insurance will only pay you when you're almost dying.So we don't have the system like the Japanese one where if you want to go to for the doctors, we don't have the kind of insurance. We have to get, like the Americans, we have to get our own insurance for that. Also, if we get those insurance by ourselves, we have to go through all the claiming procedures for them.
Alright. So they give me money if I'm dying, so can I fake it? I need the money!
Canada と日本の交わってる感じ、We have kind of like an universal care for certain people. Everything is basically free. If you are under 18 or if you are between 18 and 26 and you have proof that you are still a student or if you have a handicap or if you are considered in, say you're pregnant or you have a kid, you get free healthcare from the government.
いいなぁ
若かったらフリーなんや
そう、若かったらフリー
へぇ、面白いね、それ
で、じゃなかったら、once you start working, you get into like a health insurance policy. It's required by law that every household needs to have a family doctor. So, for example, in Japan, if you have like kaze shoujo or stuff like that, you would go to a hospital or a naika or something like that, right? In your local naika.You don't do that in Romania. Usually, for those kind of like, if it's kinkyuji tai, like you call from an ambulance and you go to a hospital, right? But if it's just like a kaze or like hidoi kaze or maybe corona, it's your family doctor that comes to your house and checks you up. And
comes to your house.
Yeah, it comes to the family doctor comes to your house, or sometimes you go to the family doctor hospital or their house if you can. But more common is that doctor comes to your house, checks you up, and if the family doctor considers that you need a better checkup, like something that can only be done at the hospital, they will give you, we call it a sending, that's like a paper that says their name and their stamp, and it's like, this is what this person needs to get checked for. And you go with that sending at the hospital and show the hospital and they...
Okay, yeah, that's very similar to Canada as well, yeah.
Okay.
Right. Even, I would say in Romania, one of the problems, because it's kind of quite available, at the hospitals, that tends to happen, there's very long lines at the public hospitals.
So
it's easily accessible, it's not bad. But
not good.
Not that good either. So in some cases you'd also go private, but even the private clinics, they are on the expensive side, but they are still affordable to some degree.
なんか日本は、まあ、あの、年取ったら70歳とか75歳以上になったら割合がさらに減るのよ。そこまでは3割、30% でしょ。でそこから上になると 20% 最後には 10% になる、年取れば取るほど自分が払う負担が少なくなるよね、
That's cool. That's cool. What the heck?
必要になるじゃん年取る方が、で絶対体調悪くなるし、その時にお金がかからなくなる、
That's cool.
That's good.
Oh my god.
日本人が留学海外にするじゃん、で歯の治療をしないといけないから、それは我慢して虫歯 で、一回日本に帰ってきた時にガーって治療するみたいなのよく聞くんよね。
That's what Eastern Europeans who do ryugaku in Western Europe do actually.
Yeah. In America, yeah, there's this like dark running gag where you have to don't wait until one thing is wrong with you. Wait until like five things are wrong with you.
Oh, yeah.
Go to a different country to get your things checked. Get the chiyo there and come back soon.
I heard like insane stories where like there would be people that have some kind of byoki in America, and they would go to either South America or Turkey for like a whole week, and like the whole cost of the plane to Turkey and to come back, the shukuhakuhi, the chiryohi, all of this combined, it's still like less than half of what they would have to pay if they were to go to a hospital in America.
Exactly. Oh my gosh, that's a really big problem. That
medical tourism.
Yeah. Medical tourism.
That's insane.
Le big sai. But I'm healthy in Japan, so I'm not complaining.
Something I noticed about Japan though is that like even for like the most minor of like 体調悪い, people will go to the hospital.
So
right, the hospital,
right?
Yeah, and like that like way of thinking is just so foreign to me because the hospital is usually reserved for like emergency visits. If you were to go to the hospital, my stomach hurts. You'd be like, go home. Like, what are you?
Yeah, go home and rest. Like, yeah, come eat some chicken noodle soup and some Sprite. That'll cheer you right up. Don't go to the hospital.
Yeah, it's the same in Romania. Because like, if you tell a friend, like, I went to the hospital the other day, they'll be like, oh my god, are you okay?
Yeah. It seems like a really, really serious thing. Yeah.
There's two things Americans fear: police and the hospital.
Yeah. 健康保険でした。 でちょっとね、次はカジュアルなやつで。次、万札が使える。
Oh yes. I have gotten used to in Japan, but will never get used to in the States and avoid it like the plague, unless I'm making a big purchase.
Yeah.
I can always trust the Japanese person to break my Ichiman Satsu for water.
どういうこと、そのアメリカでは100ドル札払って買うと困るの？
Well, that's the thing. In the States, there's a lot of cashless payments, right? And so a lot of people pay by card, they pay by Apple Pay. And then on top of that, not a lot of places carry change to break 100. So if they break your 100, they're not going to have any more cash for the rest of the day. Let's say someone else brings in a $100 bill. What are they going to do if they don't have a credit card or anything? They just have an Ichiman Satsu and I don't have change to give them. Then I can't accept your $100 bill. And on top of that, there's a lot of sagi with $100 bills. People make printing fake money, right? And so there are these mandatory checks that people have to do with a black light and like check for a code in the $100 bill to make sure it's real. So if I bring a $100 satsu to a place, I am doing meiwaku on the tain side. So never do that. That'll be $5.63. How are you paying today?
Yeah, ちょっと大きいのしかないんですけど。
Seriously? Seriously? Hey Ben! You have the black light for the $100 bill. This guy wants to pay a $100 bill. Are you serious? Yeah, there's another guy coming here paying $100 bill. Do you really not have any other bills?
Yeah, just the going to
month. Get the black light! Get the black light. Where's it in the back? I think I put it in the drawer. Okay, thanks. No, you shouldn't be really doing this. You should really carry lower bills with you around. Just smaller bills would really help us out.
You don't have a card or anything?
Yeah. Do you have Apple Pay or anything like that? You know, nobody does this. Nobody does. Here, 20, 40, 60, etc. That's how it is. That's how your experience is.
Oh my god.
It's really annoying. Like when I worked at the movie theater, every single time someone brought in a $100 bill, like a manager had to come so you could like see the money like go into the register and like we'd have to like log it. Like what time, what they purchased and everything like that, and then it would be put in a separate drawer. And then it'd be closed. It's so silly.
So if they ripped us off, we could report them to the police with a proper account of what they purchased and what they used.
もうそれさ、100ドル札ある意味なくない?
Well, yeah, I know.
何に使うの? じゃあ。
To show off.
So, rap video.
It's basically just for rap videos. That's
and Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
Vegas, they'll take it, no problem. Oh, yeah, I'll take your money, break in, here's chips, boom. I feel cool doing that. I do not feel cool paying a $100 bill for just like a grocery store or just like a beauty store or Chipotle.
Yeah. Right, yeah, because you can use it anywhere, and like they have enough cash in the register to break it, no problem, right?
Right.
And I think, you know, Japan's a pretty law-abiding society. The amount of people who try to scam using a Ichiman Satsu is probably pretty low, I would imagine.
Yeah, まあこっち人の考え感覚によるけど、でガム100円買って1万札崩してくるわっていうのは普通によく。
Right, right.
I got super nervous trying to do that for the first time. And then they smiled at me when I did. I was like, wait, what? You're smiling at me? I'm like, what the heck? And I can put it in this little machine and it does all the seisan for me? This would never fly in America. Oh man, people would abuse this system
so
much.
Oh yeah,
I mean,
yeah, totally, yeah.
Yeah.
How? Malaysia?
Yeah, 普通に使える。
使える?Romania も?
普通に使える。
My tip for Japanese people, when you go to the exchange place to exchange your money, just ask for $20 bills, even if it's like you get like $100. Right? Just ask for mostly $20 bills. Maybe carry like $100 bill with you, but break those all into 20s and like 10s. That's much better than carrying around $100 bill. You don't want to carry that much money on you anyway, because, you know, most likely than not, someone might...And if, only if, someone tries to steal it.
Right.
God forbid.
Oh, there's actually an important thing that you should keep small money with you in Romania. Because when you go to a restaurant or take a taxi, you have to tip. And if you have only big satsu, they're gonna assume like you're just giving a big tip. Or they're like, oh, I don't have change for the big ones. So like...Should I just keep it all? Because like, I can't give you the change for the tip.
What a convenient excuse.
Yeah.
ということで、万札が使えるでした。次、現金主義が多い。
Oh, in Japan? Oh, yes. When I'm behind the obasan in line and they take out their little tiny coin purse and they take so long to take out their ichien and their goen and their...Juens, I'll wait. Because then I'm going to do it to the person behind me too.
そうね、だから、まあ、最近はだいぶ普及してきたけど、PayPay とかクレジットカードとか、ICOCA とかね、まあ、QuickPay ID とかあるけど、そういう電子決済的なのが、まだ 100% じゃ全然ないじゃん、日本は。これ、どんくらい使えんのみんなの国では。
I think 電子マネー、you can basically universal.
もう 100% って言っても、
ほぼ 100%。
やば。
That's true, that's true. Yeah, even homeless people have it. Like, what's it called? You know how people, like homeless people, they beg for money on the
QR code.
Yeah, they have QR codes. There's this new credit card reader called Square. Well, that's pretty old technology. You plug it into your phone, and you can swipe your credit card and get...money from that. So some homeless people will have a phone, they'll have Square, and so it's like, oh, you don't have a dollar? I can take credit card, and they show it to you.
Yeah.
It would be like a person at a farmer's market using that. Like, they don't have a credit card reader, they turn their phone into a credit card reader.
まあ、でもそうしないと生きていけないもんね。だって現金もあんま使わないわけでしょ。
That's right.
Yeah.Unless it's like a really, really small business, like a really local like record shop or something like that, they may only take cash. But like, I think that was like 10 years ago that was the case. But I think now it's probably like universal.
In Romania, like 5 years ago when I left Romania, cash was way more common than card. And when I went back a few months ago, everyone was just using Revolut or card.Cash, now it's used mainly for tipping. Like, cash is a tipping mechanism.
日本は、じゃあそのみんなと国と比べたら、めちゃくちゃ少ない、電子決済が。
ね、自分の感想としては、日本来た時に、日本クレジットカードすらあまり使ってないんですね。みんなどこでも現金ばっかり。
そうね、
昔ね。だから来たら、あれ、全部現金が結構困るなと思ってて、クレジットカードも使えないし。でも、コロナになってから、急にどこでも何でも使えるようになったんですよ。日本。
確かに
触らない
よ、
急に全部何でも使える、あの速度が圧倒的にびっくりしてる。
早い。It's kind of cool because America has these independent companies such as Venmo, right? Where you connect it to your bank app and then you share money between friends if you want to split a bill, right? But then I can't use Venmo to pay for a lunch at a sushi restaurant just for myself, right? It's only an app used to Wadikan between friends. But PayPay, right? You can share Wadikan between your friends, but also you could use the app to pay as well directly, right? Like if I'm in Venmo, I'm gonna use my debit card first, pay the amount, and then ask my friends to Venmo me. So there's multiple avenues I need to jump through in order to pay for something. But Nihon also has, including PayPay, they have the Tsuica card, which acts like a loadable credit card inside of the States, right? So you can use it for the densha, you can use it for the taxi, you can use it for the bus, crane games, konbini, come on, dude.
Vending machines?
Dude, yeah. Oh my goodness. I love that so much. It's like, everything would be a little bit better if like businesses worked together and just held hands a little bit more. I'm just more accepting of universal payments, but they're not that advanced.
So, yeah.
Sometimes though, goes too over, just like the CCP.
None of them?
Do you know that right now they don't even use cards?
Oh, that's right.
They use...
Oh, their hand.
Yeah. Hand, face.
That's crazy.
Wow. That's scary.
Oh my god. Wow. Well, it works in Japan.
Yeah, 確かに日本って新しい技術が出てきた時によしこれやろうって最初にやる国じゃない考えがあって、でも一回これやりますって決めたらものすごい速度でみんなやらないといけないだって決まりなんだからっつってブワーって進んでいくイメージはあるよ。だからすごい速度で今進んでってて、競争ってよりみんなでなんか一つ便利なものを作ろうみたいな考えが強いから、さっきバイロンが言ったみたいにスイカどこでも使えるようにしようとか共通のプラットフォームを作っていくんじゃないかなって思う。
That's great.
That's really nice. Yeah. Nice.
現金主義な日本でした。次、
ダダダン、
チップがない。
Oh, this is the best thing.
Oh,
this is so good.
I am grieving my next trip to the States because I have to do this.
Okay. It's so bad. It's so bad. Like before, like when I was living in Canada, like however many years ago, it seemed like the minimum tip was like what, 10-15% or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that was like considered like reasonable. Like I could take that. But now it's like 15% is an insult. You have to tip at least 20-25.
チップって上がったりするの?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even though it's like everything is a tip now.Like, I went to the... Okay, this drove me insane. I can't believe it. Okay, I went to Canada, and I guess things have sped up or progressed since I've been here. But, like, when I went back to Canada, I went to this coffee shop. And sometimes it would be, like, a tip jar, right? It would be, like, tips welcome kind of thing. But it was totally optional. You didn't...
Was it Tim's?
It was not Tim's. No, it was, like, some other place. A tip jar, right? It would be totally optional to put money in there kind of thing. But now they have the tip thing on the tablet that you... write your credit card information. So even before you can get to like the pay screen, it's like, do you want to add a tip? And the person is standing right there. So if you press no, they're going to be like, ugh. Like they'll be visibly mad at you. Like what happened to me? Because I saw this tip thing and usually I'm like, what the hell, tip? Like I'm not, you haven't even done anything yet. I haven't got my coffee. You've done nothing for me. Why would I tip you? And so I'm like, screw this, no tip. And she got angry and she like rolled her eyes at me. And she started treating me very poorly for the rest of the transaction. And then, it wasn't Starbucks, but it was a very similar type of thing where you had to write the customer's name on the cup. And so she purposely didn't write my name on the cup. And then my order got lost somewhere and it took very, very long for it to happen. So there's like retaliation. You get punished for not tipping. And like, and if you don't tip a minimum percentage, you will probably get that same treatment, right? It's insane. It's really, really messed up how that works out.
In your defense, I'm expecting you are going to give me the kind of service, so I'm giving you no tips.
Exactly. You treat me like ass the whole time, so like, forget it. I'm not giving you tips.
Oh my god, dude. It has a lot of power, tipping. Because like, we have this bar trick where if we go to like just any bar in general, the general rule is if you buy a drink, And it's not a koime or anything. Like, you don't say, hey, can you make this a little stronger? Because they're not going to do that for you. They'll, like, add water to it at mm-hmm. most. But you buy a drink for, like, let's say $15. And then you tip the guy $15. 9 times out of 10, you ask for the same drink again. They're going to make that shit really strong. So yes. It does have power in that extent where, you know, you can get special treatment from tipping. But that's, like, on the extreme side of tipping. And it's just this really toxic subculture that we have that entitles us to payment that we expect from just like really, really bad service.
It's silly. But in Japan, it's like there's no tip, and yet the service is always good.
Mm-hmm. It's so like, so good that it makes me want to tip. Right. You know,
Yeah.
I want to tip because it's so good. Exactly. And then I'm like, I'm obligated to tip, and I have to. Right?
Yeah.
Like, yuck.
And so because tipping used to be optional, it's like if you did a good job, it's like keep the change, buddy. You know, you want to do something nice for them, right? Because they went above and beyond. But because tipping has now become obligatory, it has to be, you have to tip now, people give like the most minimum amount of effort because they'll still get a tip anyway, right? So there's no incentive for them to work really, really hard because there's no degree to what, there's no what? Varying degrees of getting a tip because they're getting a tip guaranteed anyway. You know what I mean? It's such a broken system. And look, I'm not blaming... I'm so angry about this. I'm not blaming the worker necessarily because they're getting paid a crap wage from the company, right? So, I mean, it depends on the cafe, but I would imagine a lot of these cafes, especially in cities like Toronto, which is a very, very expensive city to live. I think it's like easily top 5 most expensive city to live in the world. But in Toronto, if you're just a cafe worker, you're getting minimum wage, straight up. And yeah, the minimum wage in Canada is pretty high, like a $14, $15, something like that. It's not bad. But because there's paying minimum wage, your apartment is at least $1,500, at least $1,500 a month. So there's no way you can work full-time at a cafe, make enough money to pay your rent, and have money to save or whatever, right? So you have to rely on tips, right? But because your company or the cafe you're working at pays you so little, the company's like, well, we'll just make everyone tip to make up for the extra money that we should be paying you, kind of thing, right? So I don't want to blame the worker because they're not at fault here. Mm. Maybe they behave kind of poorly sometimes, but I think the system is kind of forcing that tipping culture to the union.
But しいて言うなら、チップを多く払えば、より良いサービスを受けられるってことよね。
Right.
But not necessarily.
Yeah, but you have to do it. It's like a fucking tyking.
Yeah, but ちょっと頑張って言うとすればいいところ。まあ悪い面は、そのお金いっぱい払わないといけないよね。で、それと、その、日本のチップなくてっていうのは、なんかどっちの方がいい？
日本の方
が。
When I don't have to pay like extra fees at all and I just pay for my bowl of ramen at face value, you know, right there at the freaking Jihanki, it's already settled. This is how much you have to pay. Ticket comes out, boom, I leave.
And that's it.
I leave.
And there's no like secret fees and stuff like that. Because you ever go to a restaurant and it's like the price is like $18.95 for like a set. Or something like
service
that.
Service tax.
And then, yeah, and then you get the receipt, it's like, why is it $30? There's like a tax, and there's like a service fee, and then there's what if, and then on top of that.
Table fee.
And then on top of that is the tip. So what you think you're paying $20 for, you're actually paying $35, right? And like,
the whole experience
is just so uncontrollable, because you don't know how much you're actually going to have to pay, right? So you have to like kind of set yourself a budget before you leave the house. Like, hey, I'm going to allow myself to spend $50 even though I only want to spend $20 kind of thing. But in Japan, you see the price that has all the taxes and stuff included in there already. So if you see on the menu, 1,000 yen for this gyudon or whatever, it's like, okay, all I need to bring with me is 1,000 yen, and then boom. That's it.
Yeah.
It's very liberating. It's incredible.
Yep.
It's incredible.
I love that.
So the percentage ってさ、年代によってどんどん高くなってんの。
Tip.
今
it's like, yeah.
だって前 15% だったから、今
20% だったじゃん。 Yeah, I think so.
I would say it's fine, yeah.
なんでなんなんそれ誰が決めんの？
It's
I don't know, the society, I don't know.
だってさ、いや、なんかさ、よくさ、みんな日本はなんかルールが書いてないのがありすぎると暗黙のルールが、あ、もうみんなめっちゃ言ってるじゃん、いつも書けよみたいな。
Yeah, yeah.
じゃない？
I guess so. Well, yeah. I think everyone is upset with this. No one likes tipping.
No one likes
でも 20% っていうのはなんかみんなの中で決まってるんや。
I guess so, yeah.
変なの、面白い。
It's crazy, like the default for the iPad is like 20, 25, and like 30, right? Or you can put custom tip. You put custom, and then when you put custom, there's
like
this guilt that goes over your head. Like you're gonna go lower than the expected amount, and then there's, you know.
Questions. Yeah.
Can you put minus?
You pay me, actually.
I've seen like jokes where they've done that before, but I don't think they actually.
二人の国には
ある。
あるんや。さ、なんかさ、そういうの聞いてたら、給料はさ、日本の方が少ないじゃん。まあアメリカとかカナダとかとかに比べたら、でもなんかいろんなとこでお金かかりそうだなってちょっと思うよね。
Well, yeah. I mean, like even though the salaries in Japan are comparatively lower, I think on like a overall basis, you still you probably take home more money here than you would in Canada or the U.S. I think, because like housing is so expensive, you have tipping, insane. Like a cup of coffee costs what $8 an hour or something like that.
チップがないでした。次、物の値段が安い。
Yeah, yeah, totally.
例えば、ファーストフードで比べてみたらどうかなと思うんだけど、この前ね、びっくりしたんだけど、あの丸亀製麺あるじゃん。で、うどん、あの普通のね、なんかうどん買って、
300円
で、あとそれに天ぷら1個つけて、だから300円と天ぷらが200円とか100何円だから、500円くらいだったの。
あるな。
これ500円で食べれるかと思ってすごいびっくりしたんだけど、普通のそのよくあるハンバーガー屋さんとかファーストフード屋さんはいくらくらいかかる？
Well, I mean, like In and Out is like the creme de la creme of Costco がいい place. So you're gonna get a burger, you're gonna get a drink, and maybe just a set of fries. You'll get it for about like $12 without tip.
Twelve.
ほぼ2000円。
やばいね。そう考えたら、もうあれを4つくらい食べれるってことでしょ、丸亀の。
You can buy for a whole family with that amount of money.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
僕感じるのは、日本って物の値段ずっと一定にしようとするよね。あのガリガリ君あるじゃん。あれを値上げしたのよ。で、その時に出た新聞の広告、70円から80円になります。前回より深くお辞儀しております。申し訳ございませんでしたっていう。
You saw the commercial? It's just a commercial about their whole company bowing.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
値上げしてすいませんでしたってスタンスだから、その、物の値段が、これいいことか悪いことか置いといてね。あの、まあでも消費者的には嬉しいよね、僕ら的には。でも、経済的にいいか悪いか置いといて、値段が上がるっていうのにすごく、良くないことと思ってて、ずっとキープしようとするから、その値段がずーっと一生安く食べれるみたいなところはあるよね。謝る必要はないよね、でもぶっちゃけ。
いやいや。
そう。
これは、あの、日銀狙ってることじゃないの。2% のインフレ狙ってるから、それ上げてるのがありがたいんですよ。
そうなんよ。経済的には多分上げた方が絶対いいのよね。
うん、
でそれを作る人にもお金が入るし。ね、経済回るから。でも、なんか、そこじゃないのよ。日本人的な心では、いつも買ってくれてる人に迷惑かけたら申し訳ないな、だからギリギリまで我慢しようみたいな、あるよね、なんかマインドが。
これなんか政治家が謝ってほしい、ルーマニアで。
なんで？
最近、自国に住んでいる友達からよく聞くけど、爆上がりしてる、何もかも。特に、あの、グローシリーズがめっちゃ爆上がりしてる。私ら5年前ルーマニアを出た時にこのバータの 500g が5レイ、まあ150円ぐらいだったけど、今は20レイ近くになってる。だから4倍、
やば、
4倍近くに高くなってる。
それはちょっとしんどいね。
あ、なあ、
それはハイパーインフレーションじゃない。
ハイパーインフレーション、
ちょっと怖いし、住んでる人困るね。
そう
ね。だからなんかすごく感じるのは、まあ日本人が海外に今ね、円安だから旅行したら大変なのは分かるんだけど、多分マレーシアとかルーマニアもめっちゃこう上がってってるから。
そうですよ。
マレーシアにその遊びに行く、東南アジアに遊びに行く時とかってめっちゃ安いな、タイとかもね含めて3分の1くらいで使えるって思ってたのが、今もう同じか、まあ、3分の2くらいまでタイとかは上がってきてる。
そうです、そうです。
マレーシアもそうよね、多分。
最近も感じてるんだけど、帰った時に、まあ、日本の値段もだんだん近くなってて、まあ、安いんだけど、でも、違いついてる感じる。
そう。
感じます。
で、日本はずっと一定で、なんか他の国がこう上がってる感じがして、で、この一定がいいか悪いか置いといて、 僕らだけの気持ち見たら嬉しいけど、社会的に大丈夫これ経済的にっていう気持ちはあるよね。
大変ですよ、あのインフレないと、
うん、そうね、
あの経済回らないっていうか、
うん、
値段が上げて今度は上げるから今使わないといけないっていう気持ちがあの伝えないとできない
んです。同じお金持ってても100万持ってて10年後の100万は今の50万くらいの価値しかなくなるかもしれないから、今使わないとっていう気持ちに本当はさせるべきだ。
そうです。
さすが香港大学。
でもあの日本はインフレがないから、
そう、ね、
みんなちょっと持ってるままで使わないんです。
まあ持っといたら大丈夫。でも最近はね、新ニーサが出てきて、
はいはい、
なんか株とかそういうものに投資しようっていう流れはできてきてるけど、うん、まあ使う側としては安い方が嬉しいんやけど。
そう、矛盾の気持ちですよ。
そうね、矛盾の気持ち。そう、ちょっと引いてみたらなんか上がった方がいいけど、近くで自分の
生活、まあ、一番いいのは、うん、インフレと給料のあの上がり率も同じだったらまあまあまあいいです。
なるほど、給料上げてください。
お願いします。
物の値段が安いでした。次
ダリン、
ポイントカードめっちゃある。
いや、too many。
Oh my goodness。
そうなん、
正直。
Yes。 最初は困ってたんだ。なんで必要と思った。よくあ、コンビニでよく聞かれたんじゃない、何回持ってますか。いるって。
I was likeWhat's a point card? I know those two words in English, but I've never seen them in the same sentence, like right next to each other. I mean, I got point cards from tapioca stores, you know?
Like stamp,
yeah, the stamp cards, yeah, stamp cards, yeah. You know? I get, those are my points, but a point card? What do you mean? Are you guys American Express? Do you guys have like a Chase bank system where you get points for purchasing things? I get 2% rebate on purchase of gas or groceries?
アメリカで、例えばタピオカ屋さん行ったら、薬局行った時にこれポイントカードですよって言ってカードもらったりしない。
I don't know, not at the freaking 薬局。 I don't go to CVS and get a point card there. But what we do have, 逆に we have like grocery cards. So, but they give you a discount on everything in the store. And all you have to do is give them your phone number. Like, we have a Safeway card and you can use it in several locations under the same company.
Member, becoming a member of-
Yeah, you become a member for free.And then you put in your phone number, and then it says price, member's price. And then you get to pay for it with the member's price because you have the card. So that is the point card system. You don't accumulate points, you just get everything at a discounted rate because you gave them your phone number.
Is that Costco?
Well,
Costco has to pay.
Costco has to pay. But for like just not everything but like the general grocery store, like your Izumiya of the States.You can get like a member's card, but then for Costco that's a different member's card, I would say, because you need the member card to go into the store.
Yeah, true.
You don't need the member card to go into the store for Izumiya.
お金払わなくてもメンバーにはなれるんや。
Right. You don't need the card, you just need a phone number.
あ、そうなん
だ。 It's like, oh, do you have your card with, you have your member's card? No. Oh, we can take a phone number, and you put your phone number, and then I usually use my mom's.
カード持ち歩かなくていいの。
Yeah, you don't need to carry it.
それは最高よね。もうちょっと話ずれちゃうけど、もう何が一番嫌かって、カードをいっぱい持ち歩かないといけないのか。
でしょ。Do you have a separate like wallet for your cards, or do you just put it in your wallet?
いや、本当にもうパンパンになるから、もう最近はもうポイントカードを作らないって決めて買うのよ。ディスカウントって何パーくらいされる？それ。
はいはいはい。
Yeah, you get like most.Like $2-3 off, and you have like 5%.
$2-3, 5% でしょ、
yeah.
5% でしょ、
yeah.
めっちゃでかいじゃん、
yeah.
これポイントって 1% とかなの。
That's right, that's right.
この 1% のために僕はこうあんまり来ない。このカードをずっと入れとかないといけないの。これめちゃくちゃストレスでしょ。じゃあ持ち歩きません。ポイントカード気にしません。私はポイント貯めません。毎回 1% 損してるなって気持ちにさせられる。もう、これ
くらい。わかる。わかる。わかる。
I don't understand.
本当にやめてほしい。しかもそこだけね、スマホで進まないのよね。なんかあんまりまだ。あるよ。あるけど、でもやっぱりこの、カードがまだまだいっぱいあって、それをさ、お店分だけ持っとかないといけない。昨日もさ、なんか大福かなんか買ったら、あ、ポイントでーすって、それをなんかレシートと一緒に普通に渡してくんのよ、この。大福買った後に、あ、ポイントカードでーすって言って。どうしようかな。
前に、あの、ネズで調べて、なんでこんなにポイントカードが多いかを探ってみたんですけど、見つけたのが、ポイントカードは何のためにあるかっていうと、
うん、
ポイントカードを申し込みするときにさ、めちゃくちゃ個人情報めっちゃ入れるんじゃないですか。
はいはいはい、
年齢とか、あの性別とか住所とかいろいろ入れるじゃん。 だからそれが登録されてるわけ、
はい、
そうです。なんでポイントカードを使うたびに、あ、こういう年齢でこういう性別でこういう職業の人がこの時間にこういう商品を買うことが多いっていう統計が取れるようになる。
そうです。
現金で払ったとしても。
That's right. That's right. They want to take your information and sell it, and that is the 1% that you get back.
Big data.
Yeah, big, to do that big data. So they can put like the 商品that are 一番求められてる at a certain hour by a certain population.
Yes.
They are able to put them in the store, so they get more 売り上げ。
That's mafia. I mean, that's Yakuza.
スパイじゃない、スパイ。
それじゃないとさ、店が損するじゃん、ポイントカードを上げることによって。
I think this is some startup but, with the American store Target, I think.
Oh.
They started this, because there's this data analyst from the Target who analyzed the customer's data and found out that women who have, who at certain age, who purchase certain stuff at this period of time,We'll have babies in like 10, one day later. So they're going to target the mom.
Mm.
Before the baby is born, they're going to show them a lot of advertisement, give them a lot of discount for that particular baby's products.
To brainwash them.
Yes.
Oh my god!
And it works. That's why the data is so important.
Target, how could you?
I'm not sure it's Target or Walmart. I think it's either
Walmart, how could you?
So basically you're paying with your information.
Yes.
For
yes,
a few extra, for that 1% extra points.
That's how Facebook earn money.
Yeah, exactly.
That's right, that's right.
2人の国はポイントカード？
ない、僕は日本来てからしかやってない。
We have members card for like, yakyokus.
一緒の感じね。
Yeah, America to
I think a lot of the time, like when it comes to accumulating points, it's usually attached to credit cards.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But like, yeah, I used to work at a bank, and like, I hated that. I always thought it was really slimy, because like, yeah, you can accumulate points, and these points can be used in only certain situations. But the card itself would cost like however many hundreds of dollars a year.
Annual fee.
Correct.
Yeah, annual fee. So like
Sapphire card.
Yeah. So the amount of benefits you're getting and the amount of money you're actually paying for it is just like you probably could take the hundreds of dollars you're using to pay for that card to put towards whatever you're using anyway. So it doesn't really make any sense, right? But there's things like, you know, Rakuten card, right? I love it. It's great. And this
Rakuten Keizai Ken,
yeah. This, there are some cards where it's like no annual fee, but you can accumulate points, and you can use those points. Like 1 point is 1 yen, and you can use it on the marketplace, and you can get like 6 stuff.
Yeah.
So
sometimes
you
even can get like how many times more for
exactly. So like stuff like that, it's like I'll be happy. I'll have
ポイントカードって多分元々はそのお店をよく使ってもらうためにここ来てもらったらもっといいことありますよ。例えばコーヒー10杯飲んだら1杯タダですよとか、そのだからもっと使ってくださいね。他の店との差別化を図るためにあるもんじゃん。でも今ローソンとかファミマとかさセブンとか全部にポイントカードあって全部一緒だからもうある意味ないじゃん。だからその楽天みたいに楽天って使えば使うほどゴールドメンバーとかになってそのお店にお金落とせば落とすほど安くなっていくの。だからそうあるべきなの本当は。なのにな
のに
1% とかのままじゃん。ということでポイントカードが多すぎるでした。
ポイントカードは終わりでしょうか。
はい、ということで今日は海外と違いすぎる日本人のお金に対する考え方について話してみました。いつもあんま真面目に喋らないお金についてのさ、なんかこう価値観の考え方喋るの面白いよね。日本はお金の話友達とかとあんましないとかただタブーな感じするよね。みんなの国どう？
I feel like it for the case for most Western countries like 西洋 it's like it used to be taboo and now it's getting more and more like let's talk it out like how much you're making, how much am I making, especially if you're in the same position. So like to make sure the company, you know, doesn't lowball youon your salary, even though you're making the same as the other coworker, just because you might not have the same negotiation skills as they do, even though the skills you're using inside your job are the same.
他に皆さんが考える日本と海外のお金のここにして違うよねみたいなトークがあればコメント欄まで書いてもらえればと思います。
どしどし
他に僕らに話してほしいトピックがあればそちらもコメント欄までお願いします。それでは次の動画でまたお会いしましょう。
バイバイ。
チャン、
ね、
る
登録
お願いします。